we'll move ahead. Mr. Gundlapalli Ramalinga Reddy is the founder and CEO of Hushi, is the first and only fully integrated proprietary HR function outsourcing who builds HR department and manages it as a part of business process. Sir always says the talent that you hire today makes the difference between success and failure in your future. He has recently been featured in the Made in Hyderabad book among one of the top 25 entrepreneurs in Hyderabad. I welcome sir to motivate youth and how to go further as to how to develop the nation and what should be their ideology.
Good evening, friends. It's an honor to be along with my election committee, sir. And also very heartening to see the kind of list of people who are getting honored today. You know, it's like it shows the kind of a variety and the kind of excellence, you know, of work that our people are doing. So, nenu chesi na work mottham people related. సో వేరే ఎక్కడ పీపుల్ ఉంటే అక్కడ నా వర్క్ ఉంటుంది అన్నట్టు. సో నేను పుట్టింది హైదరాబాద్ ఓల్డ్ సిటీ. సో ఆల్వేస్ రెఫర్ యాజ్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ బీన్ యునో సౌత్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది మూసీ రివర్. ఓకే, ఐ నెవర్ క్రాస్డ్ సౌత్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద మూసీ రివర్ అంటిల్ మై గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్. ది ఓన్లీ టైమ్ వెన్ ఐ క్రాస్డ్ మూసీ రివర్ సౌత్ సైడ్ టు అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టేట్, దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ గుడ్ థింగ్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ ఫీల్ దట్ ఐ హావ్ డన్ యునో ఇన్ మై లైఫ్, ది ఓన్లీ వన్ థింగ్ దట్ చేంజ్డ్. But definitely, I think what south side of the Musi River, what taught is the HR. Nothing but a human relations. Okay? Manamu sagam kappu chai daakunta 3 hours, 4 hours cafe lo untamu, which is actually very rare. But, you know, I realized that kind of quality, you know, that you're making connections with people and network, I think that is what really has helped me in my career. So I took that quality from there. And rest everything beyond Hyderabad is basically, it's an exposure, right? You know, when you go out, the lot of exposure that you get, more than education. Sir annaru, you know, nenu education ledu annaru, but I think my true definition of education is knowing the world, okay, living in this world, right? And I truly believe that, endukante nenu naa journey lo oka HR manager ga unnappudu a lot of institutions ki vellam, ante ippudu IITs unnai, you know, IIMs unnai, I used to go hire people. But then, you know, when you see, we used to pick up the last rung students first, okay, ante those who are in the last benches or last rung, not the toppers, okay. Then you realize why, you know, why this is, you know, so important is because not just only on the studies, the last benches typically would have spent lot of, you know, time on activities other than, you know, just the studies. Okay, I'm sure simple logic em untunde ante, okay, you know, oka 10 lakhs mandi rasaru kada andulo nunchi vachina cream kabatti indulo evani isukona nadustadani, like that's how they used to treat. But in my experience, HR lo nenu unnappudu kuda em chesa ante eppudu kottaga experiment chesadu, endukante teliyani institutes ekkada maramula gramallo untayi, ekkada untayi, aa institute nunchi kuda some of the best people can be యునో డెవలప్డ్ అనేది. సో ఏం చేస్తారు అంటే ఏ ఒక్క ఆఫీస్లో ఉన్నా సరే, ఓకే 70% ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అన్ ఎంఎన్సీ దే విల్ సే ఓకే యూనో జస్ట్ పికప్ ఓన్లీ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ట్యాగ్, నా కంపెనీ ట్యాగ్ ఉందంటే ఈ కంపెనీ ఐఐటి యూనో ఐఎం ట్యాగ్ ఉండాలి అనేది ఒక దృష్టికోణం ఉంటుంది. మై ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ వాజ్ ఆల్వేస్ దట్ నో, ఐ థింక్ యూ ఆల్సో గెట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద బెస్ట్ పీపుల్ హూ డిడ్ గెట్ ఆపర్చునిటీ టు రైట్ ఎగ్జామ్స్, ఫర్గెట్ అబౌట్ యూనో ఈవెన్ పాసింగ్ ది యూనో ఎంట్రన్స్ ఎగ్జామ్, బట్ యూనో సమ్బడీ హూ హాజంట్ రీచ్డ్ బట్ దే ఆర్ యాక్చువల్లీ ఇన్ ద లోకల్ స్టేజ్. సో నా ఎక్స్ప్లోరేషన్ అంతా, యు నో దట్స్ వాట్ ఐ సెడ్, అరౌండ్ పీపుల్ ఓన్లీ, యూ నో వేర్ డు యూ ఫైండ్ ద బెస్ట్ పీపుల్ ఈస్ యు నో వాట్ ఐ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఫోకస్డ్. అండ్ యాజ్ ఐ సెడ్, ఐ థింక్ ఇట్స్ ది ఎక్స్పోజర్ దట్ యు నో మ్యాటర్స్. వై ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ టూ రీజన్స్, ఐ వర్క్ విత్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్జిఓస్ అక్రాస్ ద కంట్రీ, ఐ వర్క్ విత్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్జిఓస్ విచ్ ఆర్ అక్రాస్ ద కంట్రీ అండ్ ఐ హెల్ప్ ఇన్ దేర్ పీపుల్ ప్రాక్టీసెస్, రైట్? వాట్ ఈస్ మై జాబ్? My job is to identify the right people for those NGOs and also develop them and also help them to achieve the goals that the NGOs have, right? Their goals are very clear. It is the social transformation, right? Social impact. So we work with many of the NGOs. But one of the things that I kind of noticed is they kind of struggle to have good people around, right? You know, to, because you know, you are there, you know, your energy and your passion is so much that wherever you go, it's custom. So you know, that's always you know, it's always a challenge of will it go to generations together is a question, right? You can initiate chestar ipudu oka stage lo, let's say when you're not married, when you start an NGO, there is a whole lot of world for you. You know, you are married, you have children, you have, you know, this thing. Then I have seen that, you know, a lot of this journey, the life journey itself, it will have an impact on the NGO itself that you actually start up. I think that is where a good planning of people structure, people ni teeskuravadamu, people oka structure ga airport cheyadamu, dan oka organization laga cheyadam anedi chaala chaala important. So నేను నా కంపెనీ నేను స్టార్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు ఏంటంటే ఐ వాజ్ యాక్చువల్లీ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ అట్లీస్ట్ ఇన్ 1997-98 ఐ వాజ్ ద హైయెస్ట్ పెయిడ్ హెచ్ఆర్ మేనేజర్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ ఓకే ఐ వాజ్ ద హైయెస్ట్ పెయిడ్ ఐ డోంట్ గెట్ దట్ సాలరీ టుడే ఓకే దట్స్ అ డిఫరెంట్ క్వశ్చన్ సో లీవింగ్ దట్ అండ్ దెన్ వర్కింగ్ ఫర్ యువర్ ఓన్ బిజినెస్ ఇస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ So I took it as a challenge that I looked at. I work with large companies, very well known companies in the country, but then I realized that what is that I think I can give back, whatever I have learned, I need to give back to the country or give back to people, right? I work with people. Even a smallest change that happens today also is a social impact, and smallest change that I make in the organizations where we are working, I'm sure it's a kind of a, you know, social change. So నా హెచ్ఆర్ జాబ్ హెచ్ఆర్ ఎక్కడ ఉంటారు హెచ్ఆర్ పర్సన్స్ ఎక్కడ ఉంటారు ఎక్కడైతే కంపెనీ పెద్దగా ఉందో ఎక్కడైతే యూనో గుడ్ సెట్ ఆఫ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ ఉంటారో అక్కడే ఉంటారు సో బట్ వెన్ ఐ లుక్ ఎట్ యాక్చువల్లీ అవర్ కంట్రీ ఈజ్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్ స్మాల్ మిడ్ సైజ్ ఎంటర్ప్రైజెస్ రైట్ స్మాల్ మిడ్ సైజెసే కదా ఐ మీన్ మన కంట్రీని మొత్తం నడిపించేది ఇప్పుడు స్మాల్ మిడ్ సైజ్ ఎంటర్ప్రైజెస్ దెన్ వెన్ ఐ లుక్ ఎట్ అసలు హెచ్ఆర్ అనేది అనిపించదు అంటే హెచ్ఆర్ పీపుల్ ఫోకస్ అనేది స్మాల్ కంపెనీలో అస్సలు ఉండదు అసలు ఐ డోంట్ థింక్ దే ఈవెన్ న్యూ దట్ సంథింగ్ కాల్డ్ హెచ్ఆర్ అండ్ హెచ్ఆర్ ఇట్సెల్ఫ్ వాజ్ న్యూ ఇన్ 1991-92 వాటెవర్ బట్ యు నో చిన్న కంపెనీలకు అయితే ఇంకా దూరం అది దే లుక్ ఎట్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అ కాస్ట్ ఓకే దెన్ దట్స్ వెన్ ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ మై జర్నీ టు సే దట్ ఓకే ఐ లెర్న్ లాట్ ఫ్రమ్ మై యు నో లార్జ్ ఎంటర్ప్రైజెస్ ఈవెన్ టిల్ టుడే పీపుల్ మే నాట్ యాక్సెప్ట్ సాలరీ ఈజ్ అన్ అడిక్షన్ రైట్ సాలరీ ఒకసారి మంచిగా నెలకి వస్తుంది అని అంటే వై డూ యూ వాంట్ టు రియలీ లీవ్ ఇట్ Right, that's the, you know, one of the thing. So then I said, when I looked at myself, my knowledge, not more than 5% that I was able to contribute to the organization who's paying the highest salary for me at that point of time. Then I said, no, I think this is not the way, you know, our lifestyle is very simple, right? I'm a mathematics school teacher son and first generation entrepreneur, right? So mana level of expectations of our own self is actually very less because you just live like any other you know next door boy like you must have seen in Old City I don't know how many of you are from Old City I'm sure we enjoy that that calmness but also I think there is a danger that you know we are all in a chinna baavilo kapalam that's why I was referring to saying that crossing the Musi river I gave you the example the reason is one of the point that I wanted to drive to the kind of all the members who are actually doing it here is that your scope of work if your boundary is only just you know Hyderabad you know there is lot more that you're going to lose right if your boundary is much more beyond even though I think if your contribution has to reach out to multiple locations we need to really understand the different way in north how it's handled west how it's handled and in the east how it's handled I think that is one of the biggest opportunity that I had in my life that I left I went and joined in Rajasthan. The first job, joined in Rajasthan, one of the most remote place, and from there to Delhi, and then Delhi and the north, northeast. You know, that's the area that I covered as an HR manager for a company. And then I moved to Mumbai. You know, Mumbai is a blessed place to be, you know, learning things. And then I came back to Hyderabad. So my literal work experience in Hyderabad is like very, very. So the reason why I'm actually driving this point is that today I run a company when I did not look at it as just only Hyderabad you know typically that is what happens we actually limit ourselves based on the geography that we belong to but I think my exposure of Delhi and you know west and all that we are able to build an organization today an HR company which is, you know, across the country. And we do well in Delhi, we do well in, you know, West, and we do well in, you know, South, because anyway we don't have to learn anything about South here, right? That's what we learn. So my work has always been a small mid-sized enterprises who don't have people practices. I think that is where I have worked. And we also did a lot of evaluation of an NGO's effectiveness, right? The Godra, NGOs are formed. There are about 23 NGOs we actually assist from a very third person's perspective. There is no relationship between HR work that we do and this thing. The reason is CARE International wanted to see that, you know, we spend so much of money, you know, in actually rehabilitating those victims. You know, what is the impact, right? Then when I actually looked at it and when we came out and made a report, what it actually come up is that if the NGO doesn't have a focus on marketing, doesn't have a focus on actually, you know, look like a business, then they cannot do much of an impact. The reason is very simple. You know, you are giving somebody a sewing machine and, you know, some material, you know, to make some artisans, to make some, you know, goods. But, you know, if you actually don't help them to, you know, sell and make money on it, right? So that means the whole NGO mindset also need to help yourself to make money to survive yourself and also help. And if it is a pure NGO, you need to actually raise more funds. I remember I used to have a head of fundraising for an NGO, right? And picked up from IIMs. Why? Because you need to make that pitch of the kind of impact that you're making and make sure that, you know, people join you to actually make an impact, right? So this is, I think, is very, very important. And these are my experiences with people, you know, how an NGOs really work, because I think the kind of work that I'm doing, it's mind-boggling. I think some of them I don't even know about it, right? So that means that you should be good at marketing, right? If you're good at marketing, not just only here. No, who cares if you are just in, you know, Hyderabad, right? What is the impact that you're making? You know, can it be much bigger and larger? And that is where building an organization around you, I think, is very important. So if you are not married, when you're married, then there's a whole change. And if you're already married, if you have children, then there's a whole thing. Or if you're actually at the middle age, you know, like me, then there's a whole lot of things that we can do. But however, I can tell you something, that please spend good amount of time in creating a structure for next 10 years without you. I think that's going to be the very key. And then help, whether it's volunteers or anyone, help them to be part of that structure. You know, nowadays what's happening is people are really, really fed up with the kind of work that we are doing. Right? Anybody who's, you know, working 9 to 10, okay, I mean, I don't take it 8 hours, but 9 to 10 kind of a work, people are really fed up. And I think they're the ones who wants to do something different. And there is lot of them. And one opportunity that maybe all the NGOs, I don't know how much do you know about, is that most of the MNCs, you know, especially the US and, you know, other kind of countries, those mandate for their employees is 40 hours you have to do a volunteering work. And I see these many number of people who keep looking for, arey main kahan kar sakta hu volunteering work, kahan kar sakta hu. That's because you are not visible, they are not coming to you. I mean, it's always both ways. Of course, they also don't search, they are busy in the work, but he said that one of the target is 40 hours of the work that I have to put it in an NGO work. Can you tap them into it? Can you tap them? Just imagine one building in, you know, cyber towers or, you know, anywhere, I think will be more than enough for the people who are doing the kind of transformation that you are doing here, right? So you need to really have that kind of network to help yourself. And of course, anything to do related to the connecting to HRs and promote, I'll always be happy to help, because I think I may not be able to give that much time to each one of you, but I think just one hour that I can spend on actually connecting with you probably makes a lot more, you know, difference, I feel, I think, from a social you know, change perspective. And one another thing that I would like to also, you know, mention definitely is that I have seen the NGO founders and owners, you know, when I work with them very closely, that they spoil their health, you know, like hell, you know, because you work with rural, you work with, you know, this thing, travel, you know, all that, there is no hours the odd hours and all that, you know, I think you need to really make sure that, you know, keep yourself fit and then, you know, help your organization to be, you know, fit enough. So with that, I would like to conclude that there is an opportunity, there is a way that you can create a structure for your organization and make it sustainable beyond you. Okay, please, one thing for question is that if you stop today, if you stop working for your NGO today, will it work for next 5 years or 10 years? Is a question that you need to ask for yourself and start building it. Okay, thank you so much.